Okay, so welcome to the National Basketball Performance Centre. It's Academy Finals Day, and we've got three great games coming up. I'm Caroline Bullock. I'm joined by Adam Masters and Danny Manning, and we're going to be with you all day on the Basketball England YouTube channel. We're kicking off at 12 o'clock with the ABL final, where we've got the Haringey Sixth Form and Dagenham Park. Then the WEABL final will be at 2:30 with the Nottingham Wildcats and City of London Academy. And we're going to round the day off at 5 o'clock with the EABL final. We've got Myersco and Charnwood. So we're in for a really exciting day of hoops. So stay with us. Make sure you follow the Basketball England YouTube channel. Keep up to date on the Twitter. And come out to the Basketball Centre in Manchester if you can get down and support these teams. So, Danny, how are you feeling about today? What are you most looking forward to?
I think I'm really interested and excited to see what will be three incredibly close games, quite equally balanced matchups. You know, some of the teams have played each other before, some haven't crossed paths yet. And I think we're just in for a really exciting day of basketball.
Yeah, definitely. And Adam, this is the first full season that these teams have, some of the players on these teams have played in a couple of years, what with the shortened COVID season, a cancellation last year. How are these players going to be feeling being at a venue and an event like this today?
Well, you can tell just looking on the floor, there's a lot of excited young men on the floor right now. It's been a tough couple of years for these guys. It's been a tough couple of years for the sport in general and all sports. But, you know, certainly not only being in a finals event like this, but being here at the wonderful National Basketball Performance Centre, this is an exciting day for anybody. So I'm psyched. I'm looking forward. It only seems like 2 minutes ago since we were here last, Kaz, doing similar.
It does, doesn't it? The NBL Cup Finals that we were here for in January. We had a great day of basketball then, and I'm sure it's just going to be just as good today. So our first game, we've got Dagenham Park taking on Haringey. So both teams went unbeaten in their respective conferences. Both teams 14-0. Haringey were the champions back in 2018 and 19 in the last full season that we had. They beat St. Charles College in that final, 107-90, which was their first title. They then had the shared title in 1920 with New City College in that shortened season. So they're going for the three-peat today, Haringey, and we've got a loud, loud crowd in orange over there that we can see in the stands. So, Danny, who are your players to look out for in Haringey today?
I think league MVP Chawadi Diorama, you know, he'll be one to watch out for today. The 6'10", 6'10" wing, averaging outrageous numbers this year, over 28 and 18 rebounds, 28 points, 18 rebounds. You know, he'll be really exciting to watch today go up against Dagenham's big man Hayden Ling. So I think they'll be the ones to watch out for.
Definitely under 17 player of the year in the conference as well.
He's had a fantastic season.
It's going to be a really exciting matchup. And Dagenham, again unbeaten in the Eastern Conference. Their average wins in this season were by an average of 45 points. They've never reached a final. This is their first one. So they might be lacking a little bit in experience compared to Haringey, but they've been pretty unstoppable this year. And with some of the awards handed out for the ABL conferences, we had Hayden Ling, who was All-Conference First Team. Brandon Tachoya, also All-Conference First Team, and then Claudius Pakalinas, the Under-17 Player of the Year in the Eastern Conference. So Adam, how are you thinking these two teams are going to match up today?
Well, it's like Danny just said, there's definitely going to be an interesting battle in the bigs here. Now, it's going to be interesting, if you remember, there was a big kid that played...
Jose.
Yeah, Jose. Now, he was one of those sort of, I likened him to sort of like a Kevin Durant type player, a guy that could shoot from the outside, but he could also play in the high post as well. But you've got a guy here who is cleared 7 feet, okay? But you know what? In this modern game of basketball, you never know. These guys could be popping down three-pointers too. But it's always good when you get to see two legit big guys. You've got a guy at 6'10", a guy at 7'2", 7'3". That's going to be a nice matchup. I'm looking forward to seeing how those two deal with one another.
Yeah, the battle of the bigs.
Battle of the bigs. Let's see if it's old school battle of the bigs or new school.
So we're just under 5 minutes away from tip-off. And we've got our starting fives for Dagenham. Starting fives will be Joshua Smith-White, Fabian Graham, Brandon Tachoya, Imhotep Roberts, and Hayden Ling. For Haringey, we'll have Jaden Leslie, Kamali Taylor, Judy Diorama, Amari Pond McKenzie, and Elijah Christoustis. So, teams just getting introduced on the floor, and a really loud crowd for this time of the day. I'm really pleased to see it.
Yeah, I mean, any time you're at Bellevue on a big event like this, it's going to get loud. The arena's still filling up, but it doesn't matter if there's 100 people or 1,000 people in here, it always feels loud.
Yeah, the crazy part is it's only going to get busier as the day goes on.
Yes, sir.
Definitely, definitely. And I love to see all the orange. We've got a load of orange over there for Haringey. Lots of supporters. And they've come a long way as well, this travelling support. It's really, really good to see.
Haringey not unfamiliar with the finals, are they? I'm sure they've got, you know, willing travellers ready to follow their team all the way along the M6 to Bellevue National Performance Centre.
And it's just great to see the support for the sport, isn't it, especially at this young age, you know, and you hope it just carries through to all levels of basketball, all levels in this country, because there's so much basketball going on every weekend all across the country that you can go and watch. So just 3 minutes to go before tip-off. Team's just going to have a final chat with the coaches. Both teams' coaches, coach of the year in their respective divisions as well. Piers Malson for Dagenham Park and Franak Batimba for Haringey as well. So Danny, as a coach yourself, what kind of last-minute tactics, what kind of thoughts are going through the guys' heads now?
I think right now they'd be talking about, you know, final game prep, what their scout is, what they're going to come out in. But I think a lot of it will be about, you know, calming guys down. As we said, Dagenham Park haven't been in an ABL final before, so I'm sure Coach Piers Malson will be, you know, just telling his guys, take it as another game. Okay, you know, we've got here, you know, we deserve to be here. Now let's be calm, composed, not let the moment get to us, and go out and, you know, play well and hopefully, you know, become ABL champions.
And both teams have got here by playing the way they play, haven't they? They don't need to change how they play. They just need to do what they've done to get here. Both, you know, incredibly impressive seasons. Both teams 14-0. That's a really hard thing to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, just not letting the moment get to them. Not letting the fact that we're in such an important game, at, you know, at such a big venue with a large crowd, you know, distract them from ultimately what they've been doing all year.
Just play basketball.
Yeah.
Just over a minute to go then until we see the future All-Stars of the game. And of course, a final like this only brings out the All-Stars.
So we'll be with you all day on the Basketball England YouTube channel. Make sure you like and subscribe and stick with us throughout the day, because we've got three fantastic games of basketball coming up.
Just over a minute to go then. Two undefeated sides going head-to-toe, one-on-one. Haringey with a whole host of MVPs in their side. And first Dagenham, averaging a margin of 45-point wins. What? What?
Well, there's a scary statistic right there, just being announced there, an average of 45 points win. Wow.
So I'm expecting a high scoring game today. Is that what you guys think, or are we going to get a bit of a defensive masterclass as well?
I think both teams are going to look to stop the other team first. I'm sure Dagenham Park are having conversations about what they're going to do with Diarra, you know, and I'm sure Haringey are also addressing how they're going to defend Hayden Ling down in the post. I think the emphasis of the game will be on defense, on the defensive end of the floor, but both these teams have made it evident that they can score the basketball.
And Dagenham Park with the Eastern Conference Defensive Player of the Year in Brandon Tatoya as well.
You know, there's no doubt, I'm sure he'll probably have a turn at guarding, you know, the London Central League MVP.
So just a few seconds away from tip-off. Who is going to be the ABL final winner? So we've got Dagenham in blue today, Haringey playing in orange. As players come on to court for the first tip of the day.
As these teams take to the floor, it's evident just how big some of these these guys are for each team today.
7-3 Hayden Ling. 6-10 Tudy Diorama. It's impressive. So
here we go then.
It's going to be Diorama and Ling with the jump ball to start.
Let's see who is going home with that ABL trophy. Haringey Dagenham 1-1 right here at the National Basketball Performance Centre.
As ball is up and we're underway, Ling gets it but taps it into the hands of Haringey. So Haringey with the first offense. Diorama over to Leslie. Drives inside, nice pass. Diorama's basket doesn't go, rebound Dagenham.
Fantastic find there by Leslie.
Three's no good for Dagenham, rebound. There's Ling, and he's going to get fouled on that one. Thought we were going to get a dunk just a few seconds into the game.
Yeah, couldn't get that one to fall.
So Ling's at the line, a 50% free throw shooter this season in the ABL. Averaging 14 points a game. First basket's no good.
Haringey are not going to want Diorama to pick up those fouls quickly. Where Dagenham Park have all looked to probably feed the ball in down low to Ling early, see if they can force him out of the game.
Definitely, yeah, you don't want him getting into foul trouble early.
Saying that, it's Ling commits the personal foul himself.
One each.
Yeah, a couple of clumsy early fouls there, maybe a couple of nerves there, especially from the big fella there. He knew that he'd done it.
Diorama steps through, powers inside, can't get it to drop. Ling with the rebound. Hun McKenzie over to Sharif, swings it round. Williams loses control, three is up, and that one's no good. And stolen away by Dagenham. Pond McKenzie. Williams is driving. Nice pass baseline, and can't get that one to drop. Both teams not getting the basket to drop at the moment.
Yeah, as we see Coach Piers Maslam tell his guys just to calm down. A hectic minute there to start this game.
Yeah. You just want to see that first one drop and then it gives you the confidence. As Diorama drives to the basket, he can't get that one to fall. Steal Stennett for Dagenham. Over to Ling. To Choya. Swings it round to Roberts. Three's up again, and that one doesn't go. Ling can't keep hold of that one.
Another turnover there in transition. But the basketball retained with Haringey.
So Christoutis to inbound for Haringey. Diorama working against Ling, and he's going to lose control of that one, but it's going to stay with Haringey. It's going to be a backcourt violation, so ball is with Dagenham. So inbound Dagenham and to Ling. Wings it round. 6 on the shot clock. Need to get something up here. Drive to the basket. Big block by Diorama, but Luke manages to get it in, put it back. That'll be first points of the game.
You know, just over 2 minutes to get the first bucket in this ball game. Now, hopefully, we should see the Dagenham Park guys calm down.
As Graham controlling things for Dagenham, hands it off, swings it round to Tachoya. Passes out to Roberts. Roberts for the three. That one's good. 5-0. A quick lead for Dagenham. Stutis. His three. Wesley rims on that one. Tachoya. Trying to answer for Dagenham.
Don't think there was any more parts of the rim that he could have hit there. But all that matters is that it goes in. Answer quick. Quick back with a three of their own.
And they'll be pleased to see that, the first points dropping for them. Tachoya, shot's no good. Diorama gets the rebound. Leslie's coming back. One on one, steps through, and can't get that one to drop. Really unlucky. Oh, some great D from Fabian Graham for Dagenham as well.
Just making it difficult, not fouling, but not giving him an open lane. Just making it difficult, yeah. Forcing him to take a tough shot. And it just rolled out.
Pond McKenzie with the inbound. Diorama with a tough basket. Can't get that one to drop. He's going again against Ling. Big block from Ling. As Graham swings it around to Roberts. Back to Graham. Hands it off to Tachoya. Passes out. Swings it round. Three is up. And that one's no good. But rebound, Dagenham. Great offensive board. And Ling with just a little.
It's going to get called for the 3 second violation there.
So we've got a substitution. And timeout.
Well, do you know what? I was just about to say, I think it's going to be a case of one of the coaches calling a timeout because it's been very scrappy. A couple of nervous shots going up. Danny just said there, it took 2 minutes to get a bucket on the board. And then it was almost like, it's like, right, okay, now let's start the game. But, you know, there's a couple of things that these guys are up against. First of all, it's a final. You're always going to be a little bit nervous. Second of all, it's a strange time of day to be playing a final.
It is very early.
Yeah, basketball players, they're not going to be used to playing at 12 o'clock on a Wednesday afternoon, playing such a big game. You know, this is traditionally a sort of a nighttime sport, especially for finals, or a weekend sport in the case of finals. So, yeah, it's going to take them a while to settle in a little bit, get into the groove of things. And I'm sure that both coaches are literally just saying, guys, come on, calm down. You know, we've got a lot of ball game left.
I couldn't agree more. And both teams coming down from, you know, the south. So they've obviously travelled up the night before.
Yeah.
So there's no minimising the occasion. It's just another game after they've travelled up the day before, spent the night in a hotel to build up.
Nothing about this game is normal.
So back on court, 5:55 to go in the first quarter. Dagenham with a slim 2-point lead. Diorama driving inside, banks it in, and that's his first point of the game.
Finally, the big fella can get in rhythm. See one drop. Tough finish there. Great finish.
Tachoya. To White. Nice. And that's a three. Dagenham back up to 8. 8-5 with a 3-point lead. Diorama. Pass outside. Just a bit too strong. And that'll come off the fingertips of Haringey. So Dagenham will get the ball back. Tachoya powering up the court. Ball stolen away. Haringey on the break. Layup's no good. Dagenham with the rebound. Tachoya outside for the three. No good. Rebound Dagenham. And just taps it in by Smith White.
Smith White with 5 unanswered there. Great offensive rebound.
Smith away.
as Ling gets another huge defensive stop there.
So Ling's just going to head to the bench as Claudius Pakalnis comes into the game for Dagenham. Christoutis with the inbound.
Yeah, not too sure what happened there.
So it'll be Haringey end line ball. Christoutis. Upon McKenzie, swings it round, yes. Diorama, he's going to try a long two, that's no good. Rebound Smith-White.
Brings up court once again. Ravinas. The outside.
Smith-White hands it off to Tshoya, swings Ravinas. It round to Ravinas. Three is up for Roberts, and that is good. And Dagenham with a quick 13-5 lead.
That'll be his second three of the game.
That's going to be a foul on Leslie, his first.
Roberts is certainly feeling it, isn't he? That's his second three, as you say, Danny. This man looks psyched up.
Well, it'll be interesting to see Haringey respond to that hot shooting, if they change anything defensively.
Yeah.
Diorama powers to the basket and drops in another two. Ravinas. Smith-White swings it round to Tshoya. Back to Ravinas. Three's up, and that's good as well. Dagenham really shooting well from three today.
Yeah, got the hot hand here in the first quarter.
Leslie with the layup. Nice basket.
As long as Haringey is just able to answer them back every time, what you don't want to do is get into a situation where Dagenham Park are going on unanswered runs.
Yeah, but you don't want the lead to get too far ahead as well. You can keep it within single digits. So that is going to be a foul on Haringey. Pakalnis is shooting two.
It's a nice adjustment there from Haringey, actually. Their big guys sat down for a couple of minutes. They've gone to the outside. And that's just going to show that they've got two good options. You know, they can either go inside into the high post. And if they can continue having the hot hand from outside, that's going to be their meal ticket today, I think.
Absolutely, because the attention that Ling will draw.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, under the basket. If you're able to kick it to multiple shooters that are feeling it today, that's a recipe.
I mean, if you're a coach and you've never even seen the roster before, you're looking down the stats and you go, oh, okay. We've got a guy that's over 7 feet. He's going to be a focus. So if they can find a way around that, they'll be okay.
Dagenham go 2 of 2 from the line and increase the lead to 18-9. Diorama. Bont McKenzie. Taylor's shot's up. That one's no good. Has Dagenham come back with it? Tshoya. It's going to be knocked out of bounds, but stays with Dagenham.
Yeah, Haringey can't just pick that pass off there.
Ravinas to bring it from the sideline for Dagenham as there's a substitution for Haringey.
So a substitution for Haringey, Ramon Williams coming into the game, and Kamali Taylor's going to head to the bench.
Substitution for Dagenham as well.
Roberts will take a seat, and Nidesh Chulavinskas comes into the game for Dagenham.
Number 13, Roberts.
Ravinas with the inbound, over to Tshoya. Ball stripped away by Haringey. Diorama's come up with it. Over to Williams. Nice pass to Bello.
You know, after speaking about modern basketball earlier, it's so impressive to see Diorama put the ball on the floor off the defensive rebound and advance it himself. That's such a weapon for the Haringey offense.
Tough to guard against as well, isn't it? Tshoya. Shot is up, no good. Rebound Dagenham and Pakalnis with the putback.
Another offensive rebound there by Smith-White. That feels like a sentence we're going to be saying a lot of during today's game.
Dagenham with an 11-point lead with 2:50 to go in the first quarter. Diorama spins as it's stripped away. Smith White with the dunk. Oh, he can't finish it. But Tachoya is there to put it back. Bello swings it round to Diorama. Leslie's going to try the three. That one doesn't go. Jane Leslie heading to the bench for Haringey as LeBron Roach comes into the game. Ravina swings it round to Choyas. Three is up, and that is good.
Haringey now, you know, full court pressuring the basketball, making it a bit difficult for Dagenham to get it over the halfway line.
Bello powers to the basket and answers for Haringey. Smith White goes baseline, spins, and can't drop it in. Rebound Dagenham, and there's going to be a foul on that play. So Chilovinskas is going to head to the line. And a really, really strong start from Dagenham this quarter. 25-11 the lead so far. They've been nailing the threes.
Yeah, 5 threes already in the first quarter. You know, shooting 45% as well.
Really impressive. As both free throws are good, and takes the lead to 16. Roach, guarded by Smith White. Hands it off. On McKenzie. Can't get it to drop. Diorama's there for the rebound, and he's going to get fouled and head to the line.
Now, we know Tachoya won Defensive Player of the Year in his conference, but the ball pressure there by Smith White and the whole of this Dagenham roster, you know, not letting Haringey have any breathing room.
It's really impressive to see. So first free throw, no good for Diorama. Second one doesn't drop either. Dagenham come back on the attack. Ravinas sends it around to Chilovinskas. Inside, nice little lay-in from McAlness. Stretches the Dagenham lead out even further. Roach. Roach inside. Floater's no good. Rebound Dagenham. Great move to keep the ball alive. That's just going to go off the foot of Haringey, so it's still going to be with Dagenham. Just under a minute to go. Chilovinskas.
Good defense there by Haringey.
Yeah, so you've got, definitely got a hand on that one. That's not out of bounds, so back with Dagenham. Venus. Kalnis. Tachoya gets it back. He's going to pull up. And shot's no good.
It's important now for Haringey to be aware of the clock here. See if they can, you know, limit Dagenham to the quickest offense, you know, to close out this first quarter.
Yeah, you want to have, you know, they want to finish strong, don't they, in the first. So Dagenham picking up full court. Roach. Von McKenzie over to Diorama. He's going to drive, and that is going to be an offensive foul call. So that's going to be foul number two on Diorama. So 14 seconds to go in the first. Dagenham will get the last shot of the quarter. Ravinas, six on the shot clock. Smith-White, over to Tatoya. He's going baseline. Can't get that one to drop. That will do it for the end of the first quarter. 29-11. Dagenham with quite a dominant 18-point lead so far. Danny, how have you thought coming out into that?
I think a lot to be said about Dagenham's hot shooting. You know, it'd be interesting to see what adjustments Haringey make to kind of, you know, now they've seen that the Dagenham team is going to be able to hit five threes in a quarter. You know, they'll be important to see what they do defensively. I think for Dagenham Park, it's just about remaining composed. Keep getting good shots. They're not settling for bad shots.
Yeah.
They're not playing rushed. They're not trying to run the score up. They're composed. They're getting the best look every time down the floor. And they're keeping Haringey to tough shots. They're forcing Haringey to take tough, contested finishes, even off defensive lapses that have led them to have fast breaks. And I think that's why that's why they go into the second quarter with an 18-point lead.
Yeah. And Adam, what kind of adjustments do you think Haringey are going to want to make in this second quarter?
Well, I mean, it's like Danny just said, they're going to have to get some points on the board and they're going to have to do it soon. I mean, that was a pretty crazy first quarter, because we might as well just call that first quarter an 8-minute quarter because for the first 2 minutes they were getting all the nerves out of the way, throwing up the bad shots, giving away easy fouls. But then once they started scoring, Dagenham, look at that, it's 29 points in 8 minutes. They played very well. And the interesting thing is that Link sat down for most of that quarter as well. So they've been making it happen from other places, so they're not just going to rely on the big guy at 7'3". Haringey, like Danny's just said, they're going to have back down. So this second quarter, I think, is going to be crucial for Haringey.
And Danny, you mentioned it earlier, but Joshua Smith-White already with 5 rebounds in the game, 4 of them offensive. That's incredibly impressive.
Just buying Dagenham Park's second chance opportunities that they're being able to convert.
And that's the key, isn't it? You can get those second chance opportunities, but when you convert them, that's great. So back underway for the second quarter, Dagenham with the ball to inbound. Tolvinskas. Ball's knocked away by Haringey. Bellow kicks it out. Back to Bellow. He's going inside. Nice high layup off the glass.
Way to make the defense move there.
And Haringey going to be pleased with that coming out of the quarter to break.
There you go. That's just the spark they're going to want. And spark
another
there.
Turnover.
Yeah.
Another quick turnover. That is going to be a foul call on Dagenham. So, and this is the kind of energy that Haringey are going to want to come out with.
Absolutely. With Jody Diorama, you know, being two fouls already here so early in the second quarter, it'd be nice to see Haringey find a different way to, you know, maybe put the ball in the basket, because what we don't want to do is increase the load on Diorama, and then when he picks up his third and has to take to the bench, you know,
exactly,
then they're stuck without any offense.
There
so it's nice to see
option.
The ball movement, not settling for just post looks every time. And they got a great layup there.
I'm pretty sure that Coach Frank Fatimba as well during that break will have said, and when I say that we need to start getting some buckets on the board right away, I mean right away. I don't mean let's ease into the second period. We need to start firing straight away.
As Ling's back into the game for Dagenham. Leslie. Over to Bellow.
Dagenham Park in what looks like a 2-3 zone here. They've clearly identified that, you know, that Haringey want to look to get the basketball into the paint, making it difficult there, sticking Hayden Ling in front of the basket. That's going to, you know, really, really make Haringey take some tough shots.
it's hard, isn't it, as well, because you know you've got to go up against it to get to the basket.
Absolutely. When they're in that zone, there's no drawing him away from the basket. There's no bringing him out into a pick and roll. You know, he's going to be under there. You either go through him, you know, or you go over him, or you settle for threes, you know.
Or into him.
Yeah, well, I don't know if this, you know, the watchers on the broadcast can quite grasp how big Hayden Ling is.
Yeah, I mean, it's 7'3". When you're going up against a guy like that, like Danny's just said, you've really got to think about how you attack the game.
On a great pass from Venus.
What a cut there,
Matt. Managed to finish.
What a cut by Smith White there. It's a shame he couldn't convert that. Caught the defence looking at the ball and just went back door.
And Bello just taps it in for Haringey. Omari Pond McKenzie flies into the air, manages to knock that one away. Some great defence.
Israel Bello providing the spark this quarter.
Haringey coming out with the energy and effort that's needed to pull a comeback like this off and make the game closer.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just got to forget what happened in the first and just start playing. Three's no good for Dagenham. Diorama with a great big rebound. Leslie. Over to Diorama. He's going against Ling. Spins.
Oh, what a
and a reverse. Can't finish it. What a move.
Yeah, what a fantastic take there by the big fella.
And that one's knocked away again by Pond McKenzie, doing a really good job on D this quarter. So Roberts is going to come into the game, and Ravinas heads to the bench for Dagenham. Roberts with the inbound to Ling, swings it round.
Let's see if Roberts can pick up where he left off, hitting two threes in the first quarter.
Choya inside, but too strong off the glass on that one, and Diorama with a rebound.
Seven already here in this ball game, rebounds for Diorama.
Pond McKenzie with a huge three for Haringey. Amari Pond McKenzie really put on a show here in the second quarter.
That had to be a timeout at that position. The way that Dagenham are going to, Haringey are going to have to look at this, it's right, okay, let's half the lead, they've just done that. Next thing, right, we get this to within 10. Yes. And look at the scoreboard now, 29-18, right back in it. So what a great start to the second period for Haringey.
That's exactly what they're going to want to have done, isn't it? Force head coach Piers Maslin into a quick timeout.
Yeah.
You know, come out applying the pressure. Think, this time last quarter, neither team had any points on the board.
Yeah.
And Haringey have just been able to come out and find a quick 9 points, hitting a three, making some tough finishes. Swing the momentum.
Yeah.
That's an interesting stat though, Danny. By this point in the last period, we hadn't had a basket. By this point, we've had 9 quick ones and a timeout.
And Haringey with a 7-0 run this quarter.
Now, Cass, I don't think you're quite as old as me, but when I look over at that orange and black, reminds me of the Thames Valley Tigers back in the 90s.
I was going to say, yeah.
It's got a real Thames Valley vibe to it, that. Every time I catch that flash of orange, keep expecting to see Tony Holly bounce out of nowhere.
So, got things back underway. 7:43 to go in the second. Dagenham with an 11-point lead. Roberts into Ling. Smith-White. Back to Ling, swings it round. Three is up, and that one's a bit too short. Diorama with a rebound. Williams. Leslie hands it off. Diorama. Pond McKenzie swings it round. Williams drives, and brilliant layup. Really, really tough bucket.
Fantastic ball movement there by Haringey.
And back to single digits is the lead for Dagenham. A 9-0 Haringey run.
Now, from a Dagenham point of view, as the coach, you've got to be looking at it going, what are you doing letting guys, we've got a guy that's 7'3" in the middle of the paint. Why are we letting guys go in for drives and layups like that?
We've got to close that down.
Oh, as Ling takes to the bench now. Haringey really buckling down on defence, stop after stop, and what's more impressive is they're able to go and convert them.
Bello loses that one. Smith White comes up with it for Dagenham, and it's going to be a foul on the floor. It's a foul on Jaden Leslie for Haringey, his second, and first team foul of the quarter for Haringey.
Second personal foul for
Roberts to inbound. Mauricio Stavolskis. Nearly loses it, manages to keep it inside. Obi sends it round to Roberts. Intercepted by Porter McKenzie. He's going all the way, lays it in. And Amari Porter McKenzie having an amazing quarter. Cuts the lead to 7.
And all of a sudden, we've got a real ball game on our hands.
Shot is up and no good for Dagenham. Leslie driving, he's going all the way. High off the glass and makes it. 5-point game. To Choya. Swings it round. 3's no good. Rebound Roberts. And that's going to be... No, Haringey got a hand on that one, so it's going to be jump ball, but it's going to stay with Dagenham.
Smith-White not able to stop the bleeding there and get one for the Dagenham. Roberts with another offensive rebound.
To Choya. Smith-White. And that's just going to come off Dagenham. So Haringey with a chance to put into this lead even further. Done a fantastic job to get it back to within 5. They were down 18 after the first quarter.
And here in a 5-minute swing, it feels like the momentum is with Haringey.
Definitely, a 13-0 quarter so far. Dagenham yet to score this quarter.
And this place is positively rocking with the army of orange and black over there.
It's loud. And Tachoya drives. He'll get the basket, count it, and the foul. He's going to head to the line. Gets Dagenham onto the board for the first time this quarter.
Diorama's third foul there.
Yeah, that's a problem. That's a problem. When your leading rebounder is on 3 fouls midway through the second quarter, pretty soon the coach is going to have to think about sitting him down for a little while.
So 4 points and 9 rebounds in the game so far for Diorama.
Yeah.
You're right, Adam, that is a big loss. So Haringey obviously going to need someone to step up into that position.
Well, absolutely. Looking at the Haringey roster, you know, Diorama is the only one that really competes closely with some of the size that Dagenham Park have. I think, when we hear 4 points, we think, you know, maybe on the offensive end, he's not being much of a provider. But those 9 rebounds are crucial, because those 9 rebounds are 9 rebounds off, you know, that we stop Dagenham Park having a second chance opportunity or another possession that he's bought his Haringey teammates. It'll be interesting to see how they have to, survive this spell without him.
Well, they're going to need his rebounding down the stretch for sure. I get the feeling that we might just be in for a thrilling game here. So you certainly don't want to have your big guy sitting down with having been fouled out in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely, and Coach Frank will know that. You know, put premium and an emphasis on rebounding now. But if we're buckled in and we're here for, you know, it's going to be a ball game and they're going to need him, you know, in the closing moments of that. So what they don't want to do is get him fouled out early here.
Absolutely. As Tachoya is at the line for the 3-point play, finishes it. Intercepted by Dagenham. Hands it off to Smith-White inside and can't get that one to drop. As Chulavinskas puts it back. Quick 5 points from Dagenham. After going scoreless for the first 5 minutes. Bello going inside, scoop layup won't go. Back into the hands of Leslie, swings it round. Bello, Pond Williams is there. 3 is up and just too short, gets his own rebound. And hangs and drives in. What a basket!
What hang time there.
Pond McKenzie having a really impressive second quarter. she's no good for Dagenham.
That's what Haringey want. Just keep this game and keep this game in arm's reach, you know, with the Diorama on the bench. Keep making plays, keep working hard on defense. Just, even if you don't close the gap, just whatever you do, don't let Dagenham Park run up.
You probably want to keep it within single digits as you head into halftime.
Absolutely. I mean, just reading down the some of the statistics there, the next tallest guy on their team is 6'4". So they're really going to be outsized whilst Diorama sat on the bench.
So Bellows at the line. First free throw doesn't go. And Bellow averaging 7.4 points per game, 5.8 rebounds in ABL this season. Second no good. But there's going to be a call on the floor.
He's going to have another chance there to convert one on his trip to the free throw line.
So Bellow back at the line. And can't get that one to drop. Smith White with another rebound to Choya. Nice ball movement from Dagenham. Smith White over to Choya. Passes out, three is up, and that is no good.
Haringey
can't catch. No, they're calling it Haringey ball.
Referee must have seen something we can't quite see from over here. Fantastic defensive possession again then by Haringey.
Leslie. Behind the back, steps inside. Tough shot to take as that's blocked by Tachoya, who's coming back for Dagenham. And layup doesn't go. Obi's going to get fouled on that one, so he's going to head to the line. Ken Aobi at the line for Dagenham. First free throw is no good. And second one is, splits the pair of free throws. Takes Dagenham back to a 35-26 lead. Pond McKenzie's three's no good. And Obi dives in for the rebound. As the ball's loose. And stolen away again.
Whoa. what a 15-second sequence there.
Pond McKenzie somehow manages to come up with it and lays it in.
Well, he's definitely been the spark for this team.
Absolutely. 9 points in the game so far for him. Choya passes it down. Steps inside. Too strong. But there's going to be a foul on that call. So Chulvinskas is going to the line. Second trip to the line today. Made his first two. And first free throw is just a bit short.
Both teams struggling from the free throw line here.
Yeah.
You know, Haringey 0 for 4, Dagenham Park 6 for 9.
Second one's good. Back to an 8-point lead for Dagenham.
This game feels like it's going to come down to the wire, and those free throws might be
huge.
It does
feel that way. And if it does come to that way, you've got to be looking at Ling. He's only a 50% shooter. Typical big guy. Doesn't like shooting from the line.
What, instead of Hacker Shack?
Exactly. We'll think of one.
Yeah, we'll come up with
Hacker
something.
Hacker Shack. Leave that one with us.
So, timeout Dagenham. With just under two minutes 40 to go in the second quarter. So, Dagenham with an 8-point lead. Haringey did a really good job coming out strong so far. A 17-7 quarter. What do they need to do just to get back into what they were doing that first, very first few minutes of the quarter?
I think they've done a good job of maintaining their rebounding presence despite Diorama taking to the bench. You know, they're still forcing Dagenham Park into tough shots and they're getting stops. I think they like to play in the open floor, forcing turnovers, getting out, pushing the tempo, creating a numerical advantage. They've had so much success on the fast break that I think if they're forced to slow down and play in the half court, that's where they might struggle. So if they're able to keep playing fast at a high tempo, I'm sure they'll be able to keep this game within.
They want to play it on their terms, don't they? Force those transition plays. And Adam, who's really stood out to you for Haringey so far?
Obviously Diorama's been a huge part of it, but I don't think we're going to be seeing him now until probably deep into the third period. But for me, the guy who's made the difference is Pon McKenzie. He's really been the spark for them. And you need that guy who's going to step up behind the superstar. Every team needs one, especially in a final. You can't necessarily rely on the guy that gives you the best part of 30 points a game. Someone else has got to step up and do a job. And for me, Pon McKenzie has been that guy.
And doing it on defense and on offense, on both ends.
For sure.
Obi hands it out. Choya in the corner. Driving inside. Nice little jumper from Choya. Pon McKenzie. Apologies, that's Bellow.
So quick there with that first step. In front crossover, able to just explode down the lane, draws a lot of contact.
So Pon McKenzie with the inbound, just over 2 minutes to go in the half. Kostoutis with the three. That one's no good. Rebound Dagenham. To Choya. Provinstus passed out and a bit of a miscommunication on that one, I think. So ball's going to go back to Haringey. Dagenham with a 10-point lead. Leslie. Over to Bello. Kostoutis. Kostoutis is going to fire a three. That one doesn't go. But it's kept inside by Williams. And shot is up and...
Miscommunication there by the Haringey guys. Maybe they thought that three hit the rim.
Yeah, I don't think they realised how much time wasn't on the shot clock. To Choya. Back to Obi. Ravinas is three. Way downtown, that one doesn't fall. And that's going to be out of bounds and back with Haringey. Leslie swings it around to Bello. Drives and blocked by Tachoya. Smith-White's there and just lays it in. It's going to be 9 points in the game for him so far. Kostoutis. To Bello. Swings it round into the corner. Pon McKenzie's three is up. That doesn't go, but Kostoutis with the offensive rebound. Dagenham with three to shoot. Shot's no good. And Dagenham come away with it, so they're going to get the last possession. Tachoya. Passes out. Three is up, and that one doesn't go. Into the hands of Haringey, so they get the last shot. 7 seconds to go. Kostoutis, power into the basket. And it's going to be a foul call on Tachoya.
No, just not able to get in front there, being to the spot.
Coming on court alongside Roberts. Yeah, as we see Tochoya head to the bench along with Smith White.
Haringey to go to the line for two.
So Christoutis is going to be shooting two. Chance to bring the lead to within 10. The shot just rims out.
Can't get the first to go. Haringey still yet to make a free throw here.
And that'll do it.
A positive jinx there as they get their first. One of six.
Two to go. One. Shot is up at the buzzer. That one won't drop. And that's going to do it for the first half. 40-29. Dagenham lead. Haringey coming back from 18 down to pull it to within 5 after a 17-11 quarter, but they'll head into the break 11 down. Danny, what have you seen from Haringey this quarter?
A real resilience. They didn't let the fact they were down big at the break stop them. They came out swinging. You know, they've got good looks. They went to this kind of way they wanted to play. And they were able to close the gap. You know, they really applied the pressure onto Dagenham Park. They made them make some adjustments, and actually they were able to do a really good job of closing the gap and getting, you know, from 18 down to 11, with at some points it being as close as 7.
And something that really stands out to me, so they hit those 5 threes in the first quarter, haven't made a 3 since. So Haringey doing a really good job of closing down that 3-point shot.
I think the big talking point is the fact that, you know, Haringey going 16% from the free throw line. If we look up and say that they go, you know, they make 75% of those, We're talking about it being a single digit ball game here.
Definitely. It just shows how crucial free throws are for the game. So Adam, heading into half time, what do you want to see coming out in the second half for both these guys?
Well, I mean, certainly free throws are a big thing. I mean, obviously it's the old term that defence is what wins championships, but it's also free throws. It's as simple as that. It's money for nothing. It's points that you've got to be making. And then tactically, it's how do you use fouls at the end of the game? Do you put Ling on the line knowing that he's only a 50% shooter? But the interesting stat that stands out to me is second chance points. 13 coming in from Dagenham as opposed to 2 from Haringey, which is interesting.
That is interesting.
An absolutely outstanding second quarter from Haringey, and they've been able to do what they've done and keep it to within 11 with Diorama still sat down. Okay, so an 11-point lead going into the half. Coach is going to be feeling pretty good about life right now. Bit of a scare for him in the first quarter, no doubt, but certainly I've seen Haringey put on a good performance there in the second quarter, and wants to get that guy Diorama back out on the floor. That's going to be a big difference maker. But is he going to be cold after sitting down for so long? We're not going to be seeing him, I don't think, until maybe, what, 5 minutes into the third quarter. They need him down the stretch. So a lot of it's going to come down to when does he re-enter the game and what does he do when he gets back out on the floor.
Definitely. So we're just going to take a quick 5-minute break for half-time, and we'll be back with you in around 5 minutes' time. Okay, so welcome back. We're at the National Basketball Performance Centre, about to get the second half of the ABL finals underway between the Haringey Sixth Form College and Dagenham Park School. Dagenham Park have got a 40-29 lead as we head into the half. They led by as many as 18 after the first. Haringey came back within five, and they have the leading scorer in Amari Pond McKenzie with 9. Leading for Dagenham is Tachoya with 8, and Pakalnis also with 8.
A real interesting first half of runs and adjustments, and you know, some really hot shooting from both teams. I think it's going to be a really interesting second half of basketball.
Definitely. And we spoke before, didn't we? Chidi Diarama on the bench with 3 fouls early. Do you expect him to come out and start now, or do you think coach is going to wait a little bit to see how it starts going into the third?
I think you keep him sat so that he doesn't come out and pick up a fourth quickly. But what you don't do is you don't let this 11-point lead get out of reach.
Yeah.
Okay, if his defensive presence and his rebounding is going to be what keeps Haringey in this ball game, you keep him out there. You know, you ask him to play sensibly. Yeah. Doesn't, you know.
Yeah.
You know, and that will speak to, you know, the intelligence of the first year wing. You know, he knows his importance to this team's success. Can he go out there and can he make sure that he doesn't make any defensive lapses to cause any silly fouls?
Yeah.
You know.
It's always a good learning opportunity, isn't it? I mean, maybe not one you want to have to learn in a final, but it's always a good opportunity to
learn. Even offensively, if he takes a back seat to, you know, Pond McKenzie and Leslie, who are both, you know, 9.6 points, they're both, you know, able to find a way to score the basketball, go out there and use him as a way of, you know, creating them better opportunities. So even on offense, you're minimizing the load. You're not giving him an opportunity to maybe drop a shoulder or get called for a charge like we saw in the first half.
Absolutely, use him to draw players in and swing it out. And Adam, who's impressed you on this Dagenham side so far? Who do we need to watch out for?
I'm just actually looking over there at the bench, and Diorama sort of like hovering in the background, so I think he knows that he's not going to be coming on anytime soon. But, you know, for Dagenham, it's so loud in here, isn't it?
I do remember this from last time.
Yeah, I do, but we can only hear through one ear this time, so it's like when someone shouts, it's like I lose all bearing where I am and what my name is and who we are.
And just think, this is the first game of our
first game, I mean, gosh.
You know, with more teams from the north being represented here, you can only imagine that more and more people will.
It's going to get loud. And we've got a whole set of bleachers behind us as well. So, about to get the second half underway. Dagenham with an 11-point lead. Haringey going to get the first possession. As Prostutas passes it inside, he gets it back. Prostutas. He's controlling things for Haringey. Swings it around to Bello. Leslie inside. Tough basket, and Ling with the rebound. Roberts swings it around to Tachoya. Roberts gets it back. 3 is up, and that is good. Nothing but net on that one.
He's able to pick up right where he left off, hitting two threes in the first half. You know, the shooter will feel good about that.
Definitely, and after not making a 3 in the second, Dagenham getting back into how they started the first. Bello for Haringey. Drives inside, off the glass, tough basket, and Ling again for the rebound. And with Ling back on court, this is really tough for Haringey.
You have to work on the basis that you're not going to have any sort of rebounding presence on the glass with Ling out there. So take good shots you're comfortable with.
Yeah. Tachoya driving all the way, lays it off the glass.
Just like on that last play there. Ling gets the block. He only put his arm out to the side.
Yeah,
he didn't even have to put his arm in the air.
No jumping as well.
So skilled, even, you know, able to initiate the fast break himself by taking the ball off a block, hitting a wing in Detroit, and able just, you know, just to advance the ball smoothly off the court. You know.
Oh, brilliant! Nice no-look pass to Smith White from Detroit.
as Diorama takes it to the subs table now.
Yeah, Haringey's seen enough. They want him back in.
They won't want to lose control of this game. It's, you know, back up to 18.
Bellows three is good.
A much and needed basket there.
Definitely.
Even more just mentally for the Haringey guys, not to feel like Dagenham are running over them.
Yeah, just to see that ball go through the hoop and then, you know, things start to drop.
You know, they needed a score to close the gap. They needed a score more to keep them in it.
So Diorama will come back into the game for Haringey, along with Kamali Taylor. As Tachoya is at the line. Second trip to the line today. First free throw is good.
Smith White, 10 points, 8 rebounds here in this ball game.
Really impressive performance so far as Tachoya hits both free throws. Sorry, Smith White. Diorama's shot's no good. Offensive rebound. Haringey can't get that one to drop, and Lynn gets the rebound again.
The big guy just can't get going here for Haringey, can he?
And this could be a travel call on Smith White. So timeout, Haringey. As Dagenham have a 49-32 lead with 7:27 to go. A 7-3 run so far this quarter for Dagenham. They've managed to pick up where they left off. Haringey really needing to cut into this lead.
Just never letting them get, just never letting them quite grasp hold of the, you know, the rhythm or the flow of the game, are they? They're always able to answer back, find a basket.
I think so many options as well.
Absolutely, so many different. If you look at the scoring balance, 9 points, 12 points, 9 points, they're not, you know, it's not one guy doing all of this for the Dagenham Park. They're getting the best look every time.
Yeah, the scoring split really well, and pretty much everyone that's got court time has scored and contributed as well.
But yeah, interestingly, nobody that's, for lack of a better saying, kind of gone off on offense.
Yeah.
You know, nobody. Looking like they're going to be the 30-point guy.
Nobody's taken over the game today, have they?
They'll take it from where it comes right now.
Just a real all-round team effort.
Yeah.
So Diorama driving against Ling, and he'll drop it in.
That'll be really important for the big fella. We spoke off air about him coming into the game and getting in rhythm and almost as quickly as possible.
Yeah, and he's done just that, hasn't he? That'll be what he wants to see. You don't want a couple of baskets where it takes to warm up. Come in straight away, basket's good.
Yeah, after taking such a long stint there, sitting on the bench in the second quarter, he's got to get
Diorama
it out.
Again with the floater, gets it off in time and beats the buzzer.
That's big.
Two-point basket.
That's 2 points that came off a very, very sloppy turnover there as well.
That's exactly what Haringey are going to want to see coming out of that timeout.
Haringey back into this full court press. We saw it work for them in the second quarter. Let's see if it can work for them again now.
Tachoya. Roberts back to Tachoya. He's going to put the three up and rims out. Diorama with the rebound. Prestutis on the break, and some good D from Tachoya to just knock that out, slow the break and not let Haringey get an easy basket.
Well, we was wondering what Diorama's tactics coming back into the game was going to be, and he's absolutely been the game changer so far.
So Ling's going to head to the bench for Dagenham Park, and Diorama can't get that shot to drop.
A lot of contact there on that miss.
Tachoya passes out to Smith White. Three is up, and that one's no good. Prestutis with a long pass. And not going to be able to be kept inside by Dagenham.
You can understand why, you know, Haringey chasing this lead would make a pass like that. But, you know, there's 16 minutes left of this ball game.
Yeah.
have to be more composed.
Yeah, throwing out the Hail Mary passes at this point in the game. Don't need to do it just yet.
There's a long time left. You just got to chip into the lead. Roberts. Over to Toya. Smith-White.
Ooh, lucky not to get the travel there.
Yeah, didn't quite have the room he needed to let that fly then for three, did he?
Baseline jumper is no good for Dagenham. Haringey back on the attack.
Off on the fast break again.
What?
Oh,
what a finish.
Basket. Really great tough basket. And that brings the lead down to 11. 49-38. Dagenham lead with 5:36 to go in the third quarter to Choya.
I wouldn't be surprised if we see a Dagenham timeout fairly soon. Because once again, Haringey finding that rhythm.
They've demonstrated they can stop the run once.
And that guy McKenzie, he's not going to let this one go.
Oh, what you don't want to do there is a late recovery.
Roberts for three. He's a problem from the corner. Tachoya with the rebound. And there's going to be a foul call on the floor.
A few nerves coming in from Haringey there. They need to... from Dagenham. They're jacking up threes from left, right and centre and they're not dropping. Something that they need to think about.
Roberts to Tachoya. Smith-White. Tachoya gets it back. Drives, passes outside. Shots up, no good. Juan McKenzie over to Taylor, and Taylor lays it in.
And it's back to a single-digit ball game.
49-40. And Brady.
As head coach Piers Maslin's been trying to call a timeout for what looks like 6 seconds of action there.
Yeah, you called it, Adam. Dagenham going to want to talk things over.
Well, they've got to. Irama has been a spark for them. I mean, he's come back on the floor like nothing has happened. You know, going into the basket with confidence, the way he went in against Ling there. When he was still in the game, all confidence, not backing off, not trying, you know, worrying about getting an offensive foul called on him, and he's coming and he's made a difference.
I mean, eight points, 10 rebounds so far, 3 blocks as well.
It's not difficult to address what's working for Haringey, is it? They've really ramped up the energy on defense. They've applied full court pressure, and Diorama's cleaning up everything on the defensive glasses. You know, that's a recipe for how to get back into this ball game. Force them into tough shots, get stops, get out playing the open floor, and, you know, and what was initially a 17-point lead is now
back to nine. And you mentioned it before, when they get in transition, that's the game they want to play as well.
Absolutely.
And when they're doing that, it's really working for them.
And what's interesting is Coach Maslin. It seems to be like Ling staying the game for the first 3 minutes of the quarter and then sitting him down. That's what he's done in the first and the second. Be interested to see if he comes back into the game. Ling only with one foul, so he's not in foul trouble. 9 point game. Dagenham and
Haringey. What you don't want is him being picked on by those athletic Haringey guards.
Yeah.
Keep him out of foul trouble, save him when you need him.
Choya for Dagenham. Shoots it round. Three's no good. And knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay with Dagenham. They're going to get another chance at the offense. So Ravini has to inbound.
Foul called on Choya there. That's what Haringey going to want to see, isn't it?
Yeah, second foul on Tachoya. As Taylor inbounds for Haringey. Roach. Over to Taylor. Williams drives all the way and lays it in. And that's going to be his first point of the game. Leads back down to 7. Choya swings it round. Pass is just a bit too strong and it's going to go out of bounds. Haringey ball. And this feels very much like the run they had in the second quarter.
except this time they haven't got the detriment of Diorama's foul trouble leaning over them, as he can't get a tough finish to go there. Dagenham will look to convert this way.
And another turnover. Haringey come up with it. Diorama. Taylor can't finish that one. That's no foul call on that one. And ball is going back with Haringey.
It felt like there was definitely an imminent foul call waiting there. A lot of contact.
Waiting for the whistle on that one.
Dagenham are going to have to watch these clumsy turnovers as well. That's the second one.
That's Haringey picking up on a full court press. And it's getting loud in here. Tachoya, met by two Haringey players. Ravinia swings it round, Smith-White. Inside against Diorama, nice pass off.
Hell of a find by Smith-White, yeah. A much needed answer for the Dagenham Park.
Taylor inside, hook shot doesn't go. And Diorama with the ball. Roach. Hands it out to Pont McKenzie. Got four, three to shoot. Need to get something up here. One, shot clock. And that three's no good.
What looked like a push off there by Tachoya. Three in the corner.
Ooh, and a dagger.
And they get one to fall.
Ravinius with a big three. And every time Haringey get closer, Dagenham just are able to just pull away.
Look, we question their continued shooting despite the drought. But the hard work of the Dagenham Park shooters, the effort and the time they put in practice, they're not going to stop shooting just because they miss a couple. And the payoff is making some huge shots now when they need them.
And Tachoya with a beautiful pass to Smith-White as he just lays it in, increases the lead back to 14.
Beautiful passing from Dagenham.
As we say about a guy not quite have taken over or gone off in this game, Smith-White's done a blimmin' good job in this third quarter of coming out with some energy.
Diorama with the reverse. So unlucky for that not to fall.
Tachoya on the break.
Diorama can't get that to fall. Taps it back in and puts his own shot back in.
The league defensive player of the year is doing absolute work here today. On all aspects, 4 assists, 6 points. He's finding his teammates, he's making the right read.
Substitution for Haringey with Mello, making his way back on the floor, replacing Taylor.
I mean, and if we're starting to think about MVPs for each team, who would you go for Dagenham? Would he be your pick for Dagenham so far?
I think Joshua Smith-White's been fantastic. I think his presence on the offensive glass and also just, you know, always seeming to be the guy that answers when the Dagenham Park need it.
Yeah, he's been fantastic today.
Substitution for Haringey.
Christutis is going to head back into the game for Haringey. And Roach takes a seat on the bench. Christutis doing bow. Diorama. Back to Christutis. Swings it round. Bello. Pod McKenzie. Ball's knocked away. Diorama manages to get it. 1 second to shoot. Need to get something up. And don't think Haringey realised the time on the clock there.
That's a couple of times now.
The coach is furious about that. That's the second time that they've been caught snoozing now with the shot clock running down.
They have the world's biggest shot clock counter over there with their 200 supporters.
So some really good deep from Dagenham as well to stop them. Pod McKenzie and huge block. Diorama, ball's loose. And he manages to, that's going to be a jump ball call and it's going to go back with Dagenham. And Dagenham really ramping up the pressure on D in this quarter.
Come on, Dagenham!
So back to a 16-point lead, 1:33 to go in the third. And Haringey, you've got to think they really need to start making a run now.
Yeah, don't trade blows now. See if we can, you know, go on another little run.
They've been able to do it, haven't they? It's just Dagenham have just kept coming back. And Tichoya with a tough basket again. Gets his own rebound, puts it back in, and he's going to head to the line.
That's more than just a huge and one. I'm pretty sure that's going to be Diorama's fourth foul here in the ball game, which means he's got to play the next 11 minutes and 22 seconds, knowing that if he commits one more, he's out.
And that's a really, really tough position for Haringey to be in, especially down 18 as they're going to be heading into the fourth soon.
12 rebounds in this ball game. He's really controlling the glass for Haringey, which has been crucial to their fast breaks that have been, you know, so effective in their runs.
Absolutely, like we said, that's when it's been working for them. They've been playing that way. Now,
just got to be sensible. Close the next minute out without having any foul troubles. Maybe get a rest the first couple of minutes of the fourth.
Are you surprised to see him in still at the end of the third?
I think so. And that's...
I'd actually be looking to put him down on the bench now.
Yeah.
Is when I'd be looking to do it.
Yeah.
See out the third quarter.
I think.
And then maybe bring him in 2 minutes into the fourth.
I think me and Danny were both holding our breath there, expecting an offensive call on that
one.
Yeah.
He's just so aggressive in the lane that, you know, it's almost easy, you know, and easy for a referee to call it as a charge as much as it is a.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But no, I think.
So Diorama makes the first free throw, and second one's good also. 2-2 from the line.
Oh, Smith White.
Smith White. Power into the basket.
Tough finish there.
And Dagenham just piling on the pressure here. 63-44. A 19-point lead as we're heading into the fourth. Diorama hands it off. And Bello can't get it to drop. Ravinius over to Tapoya. And brilliant put inside from Klavinskas. Diorama steps inside and manages to get that to drop.
It's a shame. He seemed to really get going now, but he's playing with that foul trouble looming over his head. What you really want to see is him just playing free and being aggressive.
And another three for Dagenham from Klavinskas. Con McKenzie, four on the shot clock, 3-2, need to get something up, and that is going to be another shot clock violation for Haringey. Dagenham doing an amazing job defensively, maybe not enough communication from Haringey on those last two possessions.
Frank Timber sat over there on the bench, he had his head in his hands, shaking his head. That's three shot clock violations, I think, in one quarter there.
And that really adds up and causes a problem, especially when you're down this much heading into the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
So Dagenham with a 22-point lead as we head into the fourth.
The other guy that I've been really impressed with is Tichoya. He's quietly kind of gone about his business. He's played hard.
Yeah, through 29
points.
Minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been fantastic.
And Smith White, yeah, both. I mean, looking at their stats, they're so evenly matched also as well. But Smith White doing a fantastic job, that especially in the first quarter with those offensive boards.
Yeah.
He's on 15 points, 10 rebounds, 3 assists. And Tichoya on 17 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists, and a couple of steals each.
The two wings are just kind of letting the game come to them, aren't they? They're playing so tough on defense that, you know, what comes, you know, is what happens.
I almost don't say this, Kaz, but for Haringey, it is doable.
It is doable.
And having seen what we saw in the second quarter and at the start of the third quarter there, they brought the game to within, 6 points at one point? It's doable. But if it's going to be doable, it has to be done straight away. They're going to have to come out firing.
They've clearly demonstrated they've got the blueprint and the ability to do what's required. It's about coming out and executing, not making any of those 24-second lapses.
Yeah.
You know, it's about coming out, executing on the defensive end of the floor, making smart decisions on offense.
Definitely. And, you know, speaking of a comeback, so we've got a game later today, Myersko and Charnwood. And Charnwood actually came back from a 63-44 deficit in the 2018-19 final, where they went 31-0 in the fourth quarter, which is frankly ridiculous. But it is, as you say, Adam, it's doable.
And in finals, ridiculous things can happen.
So last quarter underway, the ALB title up for grabs, and Haringey can't get the three to drop. Dagenham coming back on the attack, brilliant pass off inside, and
oh, Paul McKenzie just couldn't quite grab hold of that one there. That's
I think that's going to be on Christoutis. Yep, first foul for Christoutis for Haringey.
Haringey coming out with the intensity that's needed to pull a comeback up like this off.
You just need those shots to drop.
I think Paul McKenzie is going to be the guy that they look to today.
Yeah, he helped that run in the second, definitely. As Hannah Shaw doing a fantastic job cleaning the floor.
Couple of legends there on the floor. Hannah Shaw, referee Fitzroy Wallace, the legend of Manchester basketball, head coach of the Mossside Tropics.
Smith White.
Nothing but net on that one.
Absolute dagger there.
It is. Smith White just having an amazing performance.
He shot
today.
That one from the desert, guys.
Diorama tries to answer. He can't.
Dagenham Park are doing it right, and they're forcing him into the toughest of shots.
And Dagenham Park looking for their first title. Three's up, and that one's no good. Rebound again, Dagenham. Calness is doing a fantastic job as well. Not able to finish on the possession, but get inside and grab those rebounds.
Diorama looks as if he just stepped back a little bit on defence there.
And that's the worry, isn't it? He's playing knowing he can't maybe be as intense as he'd like to be. Bello. And he's stripped. Calness comes up with it, hands it over to Takoya.
To the outside, big three.
Three is up, and Dagenham, an absolute dagger. 74-46 with just over 8.5 minutes to go in the fourth. Dagenham really firing on all cylinders. They're doing everything. They're getting inside, able to hit that three-point shot.
Not taking their foot off the gas. They look a little bit more rejuvenated on defense now. The ball's going through the hoop, really ramping up the pressure. Exactly what Coach Masner will want to see.
Revius with a three. And Dagenham absolutely on fire now in the fourth quarter. Bello. Haringey really need an answer, and it's going to be soon. Diorama inside. Manages to drop that one in. Dagenham shooting 30% from three at the moment. 20% for Haringey, and Haringey are really, really going to need to start putting into this lead.
And that is a timeout.
There was going to be timeout.
A young Haringey team is probably they're really struggling just to kind of handle the runs and the competitiveness of this fourth quarter. They're not responding well to Dagenham's hot shooting. They're rushing to try and match them basket for basket, and that's causing them to take tough shots, make mistakes. The Dagenham are going down the other end and converting.
They're going away from what they has been working for them as well, and you can understand why. You know, panic starts to set in a little bit maybe in the fourth quarter, especially with a lead this big for Dagenham. But really, really impressive performances from, you know, as we've said, all round from Dagenham. Smith White now at 18-12. Tachoya 17-9. And they're just really able to take control. A 9-2 quarter as they've come out, a 9-2 run as they've come out in this quarter.
Yeah, it really has been about those two guys. Smith White's been absolutely outstanding. Tachoya quietly gone about his business, but it's been a huge part of the Dagenham plan.
So Smith White's going to shoot a couple of free throws. First basket's good. And the Dagenham fans behind us, they're loving it.
They certainly are. There's a few deflated faces behind the Haringey bench right now.
Two of two.
Yeah, Smith White 100% from the free throw line in this game.
And three of three, there you go. And a 64% shooter this season as well. But, you know, he's able to convert when it matters in the final today. Prestutis, it's into Diorama. And it's going to be a foul call on Tulvinskas. Upon McKenzie for three. Too strong.
Skips over to the basket.
And that's going to go back with Dagenham.
Haringey just can't let their heads drop now.
Yeah, you want to, you know, as difficult as this is, you want to use this as a learning experience as well.
Yeah, play hard, chip away.
Bello trapped. Gets it off to Prestutis. That pass is going to go out of bounds, back to Dagenham.
I mean, this is one of those games for Haringey where if people haven't watched the game and they see the score, they're going to think one thing, blowout. Haringey got nothing to be ashamed of. The performance has been absolutely outstanding the way they've come back into this game. 32 points down with 7 minutes to go. It's a tough ask for even these comeback boys.
They've had some really, really good runs as well in the game.
They
just
have.
Weren't able to close that gap enough. And you wonder as well how different it would have been had Diorama not got into early foul trouble.
Absolutely. And playing against any team that hits 11 threes through 34 minutes of basketball is going to be a challenge, because Dagenham Park have just been like a flamethrower here this afternoon.
Kalnis shot's a bit short. Prestutis over to Pond Williams. Pond McKenzie. So we've got a technical foul on Dagenham.
Referee Fitz just goes over to the bench and speaks to the coach. And once again, Hannah Shaw doing a fantastic job on mop duty. That's what I love about this game. You've got a Commonwealth silver medalist right there, happy to be on her knees. Cleaning sweat off the floor. What a legend Hannah Shaw is.
Feels like everybody who's anybody is here at the National Performance
really
Centre today.
Really does.
You just got to look around and you see, you know, faces of basketball legends everywhere. So that free throw was good, and Diorama powers inside, drops another basket in. That's going to take it to 80-51. Choya into the corner, three is up, and Dagenham win it from three.
Making it rain.
Pond McKenzie, pass is broken up to Choya on his own and lays it in.
You thought about it.
All the Dagenham players wanted it, but it didn't happen. No big slam down.
And Diorama, he powers to the basket, he can't get that one to drop. To Choya with a no-look pass. Back into the corner for Dagenham.
Couldn't quite get his fifth of the day to fall.
Really, really impressive three-point shooting from Dagenham.
Tough take there by Williams.
As he's going to head to the line. We'll be back into the game for Dagenham. And Leslie is in for Haringey. Free throw's no good for Williams.
Tutorial just got his 10th rebound of the game there on that possession.
Nice double-double for him.
And
barring the miraculous, I imagine it will be a tight race for M-Finals MVP between Smith, White and Tochoya.
Yeah, it's, I mean, like, they're just so close.
Obviously, you don't want to count this Haringey team out, but if Smith, White launches a three,
it's an uphill battle. As Smith, White can't get that one to drop. Leslie steps inside and tough basket. I don't know how he managed to get that one to fall, but he did. Point deficit for Haringey. Diorama with a big block. Bello over to Leslie. Drives all the way. Tochoya got a hand on that one, I think, as he grabs the rebound.
Yeah, that's hell of a vision, isn't it? Driving down strong with your right hand, seeing Brandon Tochoya there.
Rebound Bello. And a huge block from Tochoya again.
Dagenham bench like that one.
And that's your Eastern Conference Defensive Player of the Year right there.
Ling's still standing up looking, going, hey, that's my job, blocked. Unbelievable.
Prestutis for three for Haringey. That one's too short. Smith White with another rebound. So we're just under 4 minutes to go. It's looking like Dagenham are on their way to claiming their first ABL title. Obi throws himself on the floor to try and get hold of that loose ball. So it's going to be a jump ball, but it's going to go the way of Dagenham. As Steel Stennett comes into the game for the first time for Haringey. And Kamali Taylor back in. Tochoya. Got a bit of a height mismatch here with Taylor, who nearly manages to steal it away. Three is up. That one's no good for Dagenham. Get their own rebound, and Smith White can't quite put it back. Hands it off. Floater is no good. And Diorama with the rebound. Steele Stennett manages to keep it inside.
Dagenham Park won't want to pick up any more of those silly fouls here, putting Haringey in the penalty.
Yeah, and there's no need for them as well, isn't there? They could just slow the game, play the game at their pace.
Leslie's
put on a tough basket from Leslie.
Yeah, he's put on a masterclass of how to finish around the rim today, hasn't he?
It just looks like he's hanging in the air.
That's credit to Haringey sixth form. They have not stopped fighting.
Absolutely, and you love to see that as well. They've not let their heads drop, they're keeping going. And they put on a great performance today, and they've done an amazing job to get here as well, to go 14-0 and to come through the playoffs as they have with 2 26-point wins. They've done an amazing job, had a great season. And unfortunately, in a finals, you know, someone has to win and someone has to lose. So Ling is back into the game for Dagenham. And Obi's going to head to the bench. So Adam, if you've got to pick your MVP for Dagenham, who are you going to go with today?
Well, for me, it's been Josh Smith-White. I think he's been absolutely incredible. I mean, his stat line, 21 points, 15 rebounds and a couple of assists. But he really has been the difference. He's stayed calm, he's stayed composed, he's shot the ball beautifully, he's passed the ball beautifully. And as we said, it's a tough choice between him and Tochoya, but for me, ever so slightly edging it out. I mean, the index on the stats would suggest otherwise. But yeah, for me, Josh White Smith, he's been there since the beginning of the game, and he's really put in a shift for me today.
And I think he was a player in the first quarter that really managed to calm Dagenham down, didn't he?
Yeah.
He managed to kind of take the lead a little bit, and you know, when we said the shots weren't dropping and the Haringey were coming back into it, he was able to kind of take control, you know.
Yeah, that's something I'm thinking as well. He's kept a level head throughout the game and gone about his business. He's led from the front. Great performance from him. But like I say, Tachoya has been outstanding as well. Impressive double-double from him too. I mean, those guys, I'm looking at the stats now, they've played exactly the same amounts of minutes and seconds as well. And dare I say double MVP?
Well,
are we allowed to do double MVP in the final?
I mean,
because I'm
looking at those. I'm thinking they're George Jones minutes, aren't they? That's my.
They're George Jones minutes.
They're going to have to dig real deep into the box score to find what differentiates these two's fantastic performance.
I think so.
Would Smith White be your pick as well, Danny? I know earlier you were leaning towards him.
I think Brandon Tachoya, it's the three blocks. His emphasis on the defensive end of the floor is what's just going to tip it for me.
But it's a hell of a
race. I'll be interested to see who gets it.
So 2:20 to go in the fourth quarter. That's going to be a 24-second violation. So Dagenham back with the ball, and we've seen that so many times this second half. Dagenham really putting pressure defense on as well. And when you've got the defensive player of the year from the conference on your team, he's obviously going to set the tone, you know. You've got to play up to that. Sharif into the game for Haringey.
That's
one to Kenzie. That's no good.
Goes again.
Taylor, threes up, and that's good. That's going to take Haringey to 60. 25-point Dagenham lead, just under 2 minutes to go. Link to Tachoya. Into the corner. Smith-White hits a three. There we go.
I think Smith-White can hear us talking about the MVP and says, I'm going to throw this one in for you now,
he's like,
guys.
Guys, stop debating.
Yeah, stop debating. See if Tachoya comes up with something.
And Diorama just puts it back in.
What's great to see is neither of them are forcing it. They must have an awareness of the MVP and, you know, the fact that both of them had a great game, but they're still just playing free, making good decisions.
Yep, not rushing anything, and that's really impressive to see as well, especially at such a young age.
Yeah, very, very mature performance is what I was about to say there.
And you're right, I'm looking at the box score now to the second. I think they must have checked out of the second half together.
I'm actually going to predict a joint MVP here. Who decides? I'm glad it's not down to us, but...
Yeah, we never know. Somebody might walk past the table in a minute with a piece of paper.
Yeah, who do you think, Cass? It's on you to decide.
So Haringey, just under 90 seconds to go. Dagenham looking to take their first ABL title. Taylor for three. No good. Link with the rebound. And Tachoya. Link. Smith-White. And an amazing no-look pass into Cadell. And I think Diorama got a hand on that one, but it still went in.
Smith-White digging into his bag of tricks there for that no-look pass.
We go to Choya with the dunk, lobs it home.
He loves it.
And that's what the crowd's been waiting for.
And suddenly the other side of the gym that's all wearing blue has gone a bit louder.
45 seconds to go. Smith-White swings it round, Ling. Cadell, Tachoya, passes out, 10 to shoot. Drives inside, and that's just going to go out of bounds. So Haringey, 26.1 on the clock. Chance to take a shot if they want to.
So we enter his final moments. ABL, let's hear it for all of these athletes on court in this final.
And they're just going to sweep it around Diorama with a long two. Doesn't hit that one into the hands of Tachoya. And that is going to do it. Dagenham Park are your ABL champions for the first time in their history. Josh Smith-White with 26 points and 15 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 steals. Brandon Tachoya, 19 points, 13 rebounds, 10 assists. We've got a triple-double. 3 steals, an incredible all-round performance from Dagenham as well, as they take home the first title in their history. 92-62, a huge 30-point win from Dagenham. Danny, what an impressive performance we've seen today.
Absolutely fantastic. They kept calm when Haringey had their runs. They made shots when it mattered. They made the right decisions. They played excellent defense. And they are, you know, well-deserving ABL champions.
Absolutely. Adam?
Well, yeah, well-deserved. I mean, we've seen a couple of outstanding performances there from Tachoya and from Josh Smith-White there. Commiserations to Haringey, who put on a very, 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 very brave performance, especially in the first half. Con McKenzie was the guy that impressed for me, as well as Diorama. It's like we said, though, you know, had Diorama stayed in the game, would it have been a different story? But the point of the matter is he didn't stay in the game.
Yeah.
And their most important player didn't have the final that he would have wanted to have. But congratulations to Dagenham, an absolutely outstanding fourth quarter there. And who wants to call this MVP? Because I sure don't. But
I mean,
I'm
Tachoya
sticking with Smith White because of that pass at the end there, because that was beautiful.
Tachoya with Tachoya, his last pass, went for a triple double.
Yeah. So it's pretty much got to be him, right?
I don't think you're too far off with that co. I wouldn't be surprised if we hear a co MVP.
Do you know what? I'm going to rally for it right now. I think it's the commentary team. I think.
Nobody's walking over to tell us to stop saying it.
Nobody's saying
that's
it.
Our so that's our decision.
It's a double MVP.
They put on a show that everybody in here's loved to see.
They did, and I won't do any post-game interviews unless it's both of them.
An absolutely fantastic performance from Dagenham to take a 30-point win today over Haringey. Haringey led by Diorama, 18 points, 17 rebounds, an incredible performance. And
you know, the under-17 player of the year, he's got a couple more years at this level and he'll learn from this. It's a valuable experience, isn't it? They'll only get better.
Exactly, yeah. And, all, you know, sometimes you forget how young these guys are playing today as well, but they'll use this. It's a great experience for them, and real credit to Haringey as well for keeping going as well and really trying to claw their way back into it. Dagenham just proved too strong in the end. So massive congratulations for Dagenham. A 92-62 win. We'll bring you some interviews with the MVP once it's been decided. So make sure to stick with us, and then we will be back with you at 2:30 for the WEABL final, where the Nottingham Academy Wildcats are taking on the City of London Academy. So teams will get their presentations, get some runners-up trophies, and then the winners trophies and MVP presentation. Haringey will go up and collect their runners-up medals.
Number 7, Adialum Sharouf. Number 8,
before, just again a really impressive performance, and to go undefeated the whole season as well.
It's a shame that their season's going to end with a sour taste, but actually what they've done this year is fantastic. Going undefeated and, you know, in their own league is just, it's a fantastic achievement.
And coming up, you know, both teams have been very dominant in their conferences as well. And Dagenham, as we mentioned before, nearly an average of a 45-point win in competition. So, hey, they're under the average, which, you know, we might not mean a lot to them at the moment when you look at that. But you've got to, you know, take some credit in that as well.
And absolutely, a couple of different shots full, a couple of different decisions. Maybe Diorama stays in the game a bit longer. But they demonstrated they had what it takes to come back into the game today.
Absolutely, yeah. And, you know, a few free throws go another way and things. You know, you don't know how things change once you either, you know, maybe you can come back and get into a league. Things completely change. But a really, really solid, really dominant performance from Dagenham.
And now, ladies and gents, of course, every final needs one, your MVP.
So here we are, MVP presentation at the ready.
13 rebounds, 10 assists, 3 steals, 3 blocks from Dagenham Park. Number 11,
it is Brandon Tuchoya with a triple-double. 21 points, 14 rebounds, 10 assists, 3 steals, 3 blocks.
Huge congratulations to the Dagenham Park captain. He put on an absolute show today on both ends of the floor. You know, incredibly well-deserving MVP.
Having an incredible week as well, named Defensive Player of the Year in the Eastern Conference, All-Conference First Team as well. A player with a really bright future ahead of him.
And he came out onto the biggest stage and he backed it all up. Absolutely fantastic.
And that can be tough to do, can't it? You know, you can have, you know, finals are a whole different animal. Playoffs, finals, it's a different beast.
He was not fazed by the bright lights of the National Performance Center in this crowd. He came out and he put on an absolute show. Congratulations to him.
So Dagenham collecting their winners' medals.
It's not only a huge moment for the individuals, but it's a huge moment for the program, isn't it? Getting their first,
title. And it's, you know, it's a long, like you said before, it's a long trip up here as well. You know, they're going to be celebrating on the way back down. But yeah, and a great achievement to do as well. So when you've got a program and you've been able to grow it and develop that talent, and then you reach the pinnacle, you make it, you come away with the win in the final. It's a great achievement.
Some of those players have, you know, haven't had the opportunity to play in a finals like this because of, you know, the world circumstances, but they definitely made the most of it when they were here, didn't they?
Yeah. So again, huge congratulations to Dagenham and a great game from Haringey as well. So that's going to do it for the ABL finals. Dagenham take the title.
So head up to the presentation area to Jamal Anderson for your final winning clap of the 2022 season captain of Dagenham Park.
As Dagenham are going to get presented. Dagenham get the presentation with the trophy. And Tuchoya goes to collect it from Jamel Anderson.
Of 2022, Dagenham Park!
And great celebration from Dagenham. So that's going to do it for the ABL final. We're going to try and grab some interviews, so stay tuned to the channel, but we'll be back with you at 2:30 for the WEABL game with the Nottingham Academy Wildcats taking on the City of London.
21 points.
Brandon, congratulations. That was an outstanding performance, my guy. Triple double, 21 points, 14 rebounds, and 10 assists. You were feeling it today, right?
Yeah, I was. You know, it just, the team told me, Brandon, just go do your thing. So he did, man. Went out, got the dub.
But they wouldn't go away at the start of the game. You went out to that big lead. Yeah. Did it take you by surprise when they came? Because at times they brought that big back to within 6 or 7 points.
Yeah, it did. What we did, we went into a timeout, just a few adjustments on the coach, and then, back to normal, you know. Back to our style of basketball.
Yeah. You also got their main guy, Durant, into foul trouble quite early on. Was that something that you guys were aware of at halftime, thinking, we've got him in foul trouble here?
That means
you're probably not going to see him till way into the third quarter. Is that something that you were aware of?
Yeah, of course. We see him in foul trouble early, so we decided that we should, you know, carry on driving to the paint. If he's there, put him in foul trouble even more. And then, use that to our advantage.
Well, congratulations on the MVP.
Thank you, and Josh,
you led from the front. That's an outstanding performance.
Dangerous duo.
How much do you guys love playing together?
That's amazing, man. Me and him, you know, dangerous duo, you know. Best duo in the ABL, man. I said it right here. Beautiful.
Well, hey, man, congratulations. Go and enjoy it with your teammates. That was outstanding.